Good morning, student. Today I am going to start a new chapter, Self, the Unit of Life. So this is not a new chapter to all of you. You already have studied in class 9, Cell and Different Cell Organelles. Okay? So all of you know that all living organisms, the body, so that is composed of cell. So we can define cell as a fundamental, structural and functional unit of all living organisms. So why it is called structural? Because it is making structure or body of living organism. And why it is called functional? Because all the physiological and the metabolic activities they are going on in each and every cell. Okay? So either you can find out there are unicellular organisms where the body is composed of one single cell, or there are multicellular organisms or the body that is composed of many cells. Alright? Then the next concept, that is cell theory. Cell theory was proposed in the year 1838 by two scientists, Sladen and Swan. M. Sladen, who was a German botanist, he observed different types of the plants and he noticed different types of the plant cell. And also he proposed that different types of the plant cells, they can join together, they can function together to form the tissue. P. Swan, who was a British zoologist, he studied different types of the animal cells and reported that in animal cell, the plasma membrane, that is the outermost boundary, whereas in the plant cell, there is another membrane which is called cell wall. So the plant cell is having cell wall as well as the cell membrane, whereas the animal cell is only having cell membrane or plasma membrane. So together, whatever their observation was that, they proposed as cell theory. But they did not explain how the cell is dividing or how the cell is developing from pre-existing cell. Another scientist, Rudolf Virchow, he explained that new cells develop from the pre-existing cell. So he was a scientist who explained that a new cell is developing from already the cell which is existing there. Because all of you also know that because the process of the cell division, so that was discovered quite late. And you know that when a cell is dividing, then from that single cell, two new cells they are developing. So that explanation, so that was given by the Rudolf Virchow, and he explained that how the new cell is developing from the pre-existing cell. So at last, all the main points they were combined together, and the cell theory which was proposed, the main points are all living organisms, they are composed of cell, and all the cells they are developing from pre-existing cell. So when we discuss about the shape and the size of the cell, that is variable. In different type of the organism, the shape, that is also variable. In some of the organism, you can find out it is small in the size, in some it is bigger in the size. Or in the same organism also, in the different part of the body, you can see the shape, so that is variable. Depending on what kind of the role or the function, so that is carried out by a particular cell. Similarly, if you take the size, so that is also variable. For example, if you take the shape of the bacteria, then the bacteria, it is found in four different shapes: bacillus, coccus, spirillum and the vibrio. Okay? So like for example, suppose you take the human body, in the human body also the neurons, so these are all the longest cell in the body. And in the other parts of the body, you can find out either they are spherical in the shape or they are hexagonal in the plant cell. So that is variable. Now we will discuss about prokaryotic cell. Prokaryotic organisms, where the body is composed of one single cell, the organisms are bacteria, eukaryotic algae, mycoplasma and the PTL. And these organisms, they have only one single cell. So what are the character of the prokaryotic cell? Prokaryotic cell is having cell wall. All of you know that cell wall, so that is the important character of the plant cell. It is not present in animal cell. But in prokaryotic cell, cell wall, so that is present surrounding cell membrane. And inside cell membrane, the fluid portion which is present, so that is called cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, there is no well-defined nucleus, DNA is naked. Like as in the eukaryotic cell, the chromosome or the DNA, so that is surrounded by nuclear membrane, and nucleus, that is a spherical structure which is generally situated in the central part of the cell. But here you can see that there is no nuclear membrane. So naturally the DNA of the chromosome, so that is called naked, and it is found freely scattered in the cytoplasm, but not all over the cytoplasm, but in some particular case we can find out the DNA without nuclear membrane. In addition to genomic DNA, small circular DNA is present called plasmids. So here in most of the prokaryotic cell you can find out if this is the main DNA which is called genomic DNA, that besides this DNA also in cytoplasm there are small circular DNA and these are called plasmid. So the plasmids, they are autonomous unit. That means they are independent unit. They are not depending on the genomic DNA. They can multiply themselves. They are not depending for the multiplication on the main DNA. Okay? And these plasmids, they are having some genes which are having some specific character. For example, antibiotic resistance gene. For example, one bacteria which is not having plasmids, then the bacteria is not resistant to antibiotic, any particular antibiotic, for example, ampicillin. For example, one bacteria is having the plasmid, which is having the antibiotic resistant gene for ampicillin. Now the bacteria is resistant to ampicillin. So plasmids, these are all the circular small DNA which are found in the cytoplasm, and they are autonomous unit because they can replicate themselves and they carry some important gene which can express to produce that specific character. So these are all the character of the prokaryotic cell. And the another point is that all the cell organelles, they are missing. In the absence of the cell organelle, plasma membrane is making some folds, and these structure are called mesosome. So mesosome is responsible for all metabolic activities of the cell. Now we will discuss about different character of bacteria cell. Bacteria, so that is a prokaryotic organisms. In bacteria there are three distinct layer. The outermost one is called glycocalyx, then the second layer is cell wall, and the inner most layer is cell membrane. So there are three different layer are there, and these are protective in function. If glycocalyx is loose, then it is called slimy layer, and if it is tight and tough, then that is called capsule. So in some of the bacteria you can see there is slimy layer is present, and in some other bacteria there are capsules, they are present. Bacteria is also classified, as I told you, depending on the shape of the bacteria. They are classified into coccus, spirillum, and the vibrio, and the spirillum, coccus, bacillus, vibrio, and spirillum. Four different type of bacteria. Similarly, depending on the stain, stain is a color. We are using to stain the bacteria. So that we can see the bacteria when we are making slide, then we are using different kind of the color of the dye, so that the bacteria which is white or the transparent, that can be visible under the microscope. So the stain which is used to stain the bacteria and to color the bacteria, the name of the stain is Gram stain. And the bacteria is staining Gram stain, and the bacteria is seen blue under the microscope, then those kind of the bacteria, they are called Gram positive bacteria. And if the bacteria is not taking the stain, it is white in color, then the bacteria is called Gram negative bacteria. So depending on the stain also, we are classifying bacteria into Gram positive or Gram negative. Then all the cell organelles, they are missing. In the absence of the cell organelle, the cell membrane is making folds, and these folds are called mesosome. So the mesosome is present either in the form of the vessel, vesicle, or tube, so that is called tubule, or lamella, small rod-like structure. So the mesosome, that is found in different shapes. Then the mesosome is helping in the formation of the cell wall, DNA replication, and the respiration and photosynthesis. If photosynthetic pigments, they are present in mesosome. Bacteria, some of the bacteria, they are motile, they are moving, and those kind of the bacteria, they are having flagella. So the flagella, that is the locomotory organ which is helping the organism to move. And some bacteria which are non-motile, they are not having flagella. Besides flagella also, small hair-like structure which are present, these are called pili. And pili are the fine tube-like structure which are developing from the outermost layer of the bacterial cell, and it is helping in sexual reproduction. Bacteria is a very simple and primitive organism. Generally, it is reproducing asexually. But when two bacteria they come in contact with each other, then there is formation of a small tube in between them, and a part of the DNA from one bacteria can be transferred to another bacteria with the help of the tube. So that tube is called pili. Similarly, a small bristle, fine bristle-like structure which is developing from the outermost layer of the bacteria, they are also called fibri. And fibri is helping the bacteria to attach to rock. If the bacteria is found in the water, then the fibri, so that is helping the bacteria to combine or to join to attach to the rock. Only cell organelle which is present in bacterial cells, so that is the ribosome. And rest of the cell organelles they are missing. In the absence, mesosome is carrying the role of all different organelles. Okay. Now the ribosome, what is the function of the ribosome? Protein synthesis. And the type of the ribosome which is present in bacterial cell, that is called 70S ribosome. There are two types of ribosome. 80S ribosome is found in eukaryotic cell and 70S ribosome is present in prokaryotic cell. And 70S ribosome, it can be dissociated into two subunits. One is 30S, another is 50S. When many ribosomes they are present together, then that is called polysome. Because when they are preparing the protein, then this is messenger RNA molecule, and many ribosomes they may be found to be present together on messenger RNA, and that is called polysome. There are many inclusion bodies. These are all the rhizome material which are present in the cytoplasm. For example, phosphate granules, CRF isogen granules, glycogen granules, and gas bacteria. So this is all about